Hello, today in this video we are going to discuss about how to define form view and tree view for the model we have created. In our earlier videos we have shown you how to define new model, and as well as we have shown you how to define new menu at section. So we already have created the model, that is patient model, and we have defined menu like hospital and patients. If you go to the pie chart, you can see this is our model we have working on. In the XML file you can see we have defined a menu called hospital. Under that hospital we have created another submenu called patients with the action as action parent, action patient. In the action patient you can see that there is two view modes, that is tree view and form view. Yet we haven't defined those views, so let's see how we can define the form view and tree view for the model hospital.patient. So for that I will copy a form view from an existing code. So I will make search like this. So you can see this is the form view for some of the leads record. I will just copy this and I will paste it here inside our XML file, that is in the patient.xml file. So I will remove the unnecessary fields now. So that we can start from the first. So I just removed many fields from here. So this is a base structure of a form view. For this record we have to give a name, so I will give the name like patient form model is ir.view, and in the model name we have to define which model has to be displayed inside the form. So I will copy the hospital.patient name and paste it here. Here we can give the name accordingly. We have to give a name for the form. I will give hospital.patient.form like that, and field name archetype XML, and this is how we can define a form. So inside the string of the form I will give us patients. So this is the basic structure of defining a form. Then inside this form we have to add the fields. So I will open our model, that is I will open the patient.py file. So inside this we have already defined fields like patient name, patient age, notes and images. So right now I will add this field to the form. Suppose if you check the form now, you can see this is the order in which the fields are arranged. So yet we haven't defined the form view. You can see you check here, if you click the edit form view, you can see it's all empty because this is the system generated form view. So we have to define the form. So I will define this, copy these fields and paste it inside the form view. So I will give the field definition like this, field name equal to, paste it here. So I have added one field. So I will just press the Control D. So I will copy the rest of the field names like patient age, paste here. And notes here, and image field I'll copy and paste it here. So we have add all the four fields we have defined in the model here in the view. So now as we have defined the form view, simply I'll just upgrade the module to see the change. I'll go to the apps menu and I will upgrade the module. Okay, the module is getting upgraded. Okay, so now we'll go to the hospital menu. If I click the create button, you can see the change. Earlier there was labels and everything was there. Right now there is no label, only four fields. So why the field label is not coming? The reason behind that is we have to define the fields inside a group tag. So if the fields are not defined inside a group tag, the field labels won't be visible. So I will paste the fields inside the group tag. I will remove the unnecessary lines. Okay, now I will upgrade the module again. To apps, click upgrade button. So don't forget, if the field label is missing, you have to check whether there is group tag given. So module get upgraded. I will go to hospital menu again. If I click create button, you can see the tag has been, field label is getting visible. So now if we, I will open another form in another tag, you can see if I go to the sales section, sales module, and if I open the quotation, you can see fields are placed in two sides of the screen, that is customer invoice delivery, quotation templates are in this side, and validity and payment in other terms. So let's see how we can split our form into two sides, that is name age here in this side and notes in the other side. So I will show you for how to do that. For that we have to do like that. We have to define a group tag, and inside the group we have again has to create another group, and I will create group again, and I will copy the patient name, control X, and put it here, patient age, cut control X and put it here, and let image and note stay there outside. This is a big group, you can see this is a big group. If we keep a little space here, this is a big group, and inside a group another two subgroups are made, and fields are placed in this patient age like this. So now I will upgrade the module. Go to apps and click upgrade button. So if I go to the hospital menu, you can see the name gets this side and age goes to the opposite side. That's because we have created a big group, and inside that group two groups are given, that is this is what you see in the right side and this is what you see in the left side, and followed by notes and images. So if you check the sale module again, you can see a sheet like object here. You can see this things border here, this is a sheet like things you can see inside this form, but the same is invisible here. So let's see how we can add it here. For that we have to add sheet tag, and inside the sheet tag I will cut it here from here, control X and put it inside the sheet tag, and correct the indentation. Okay, now I will upgrade the module. See, right now we have form like this. So I will go apps and upgrade the module. Okay, the module is upgrading. If I go to hospital, you can see the sheet get added, this thing. So this is how we can simply define a form view. Here we will enter the name, age, the note, test patient, save it. Okay, so we have created one patient. So this is how you can simply define a form view, like name, age, note and image. Okay, suppose, okay, then we will go to the tree view. Right now in the tree view we are only seeing id of the created record. Suppose from the tree view we have to see the name, age, etc., but here only we are getting id only. So now let's move and design the tree view. For that I will copy this entire thing, control C and copy everything and paste it here itself, and instead of form I will define tree, string equal to patients. So I will change the id to patient tree, and here I will update the name as patient dot tree. The model is same. So inside this tree tag we have to define the fields. So I will copy this field, patient name, control C, and I will paste it here. Also I will copy the patient age, application age. Also, I will copy the not field. So this is how we can simply define a tree view. We have to ID must be unique. We have to give the model name and this tag tree. Here we use form tag. You can see form. Here we use tree. So also we can add some comments here. Tree view of the patient model. Same, I will copy Ctrl C and paste it here. This is from the tree view. Let's form view. So this is how we can define the tree view. Now I will upgrade the module. No need to restart the service as it is the XML file. Go to apps menu, click upgrade button. The module is getting installed. Earlier when we checked in the tree view, we only see ID. Now you can see, if you go to hospital, you can see name, age, nodes get added in the tree view. I'll create one more patient, ABCD, with age 40, fever, okay, like that. Okay, you can see this records here. So this is how you can define the tree view. So this is all about how to define the form view and tree view for the added menu. Just this, go to code and see. I will enlarge the screen. So this is how we added the form view for the menu. Just you have to use form tag. Inside the form, we have given a sheet, and inside the sheet, we have this group, those these groups. If the groups is not there, the field label won't be visible. And for the tree view, this is what we have done. So this is all about how to define the tree view and form view for the menu. If you have any queries, you can comment it out. We will get back to you as soon as possible. Please subscribe the channel for more Odoo development updates. Thank you.